Hello, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Hannah and I'm a part-time reseller on the Poshmark app. I have the results of another Poshmark experiment for you today and I'm super excited because this is something that's kind of personal to me and it's something that I've been doing for a long, long time. So I was honestly pretty nervous to put it to the test and like see what the outcome was gonna be and if my way that I've been doing for like a year now is actually beneficial or not, or was it just a huge waste of time? We will see. In this experiment, I tested out what was gonna bring me the most sales. Would it be just sending offers to likers on its own through the offer feature, or does adding that item to a bundle and leaving that person a comment, letting them know that you sent them a message, have any positive impact? As I kind of mentioned before, I really wanted to do this experiment because for as long as I can remember, probably over a year now, I have sent offers to likers a very specific way. Whenever somebody likes something from my closet, I always follow that person, I add that item to their bundle, I send them a little message or a comment on the bundle saying, hey, I sent an offer your way, let me know if it sounds good or if you have any questions. And then I go back to the listing and I hit that offer feature and I send them the offer that way. If it is actually a bundle of multiple items, I will send the offer through the bundle feature because I like to send free shipping with those. But for single items, I always go back to the listing itself and send the offer that way. My rationale for doing it this way for so long is I always felt like it was a little extra like personal touch that I could add to it rather than just sending an offer their way. I felt like it was beneficial for me to reach out to that person, sort of like start the conversation. A lot of times people will actually reply back to me and they will ask a question or they'll say, oh, I love it, but I have to wait until payday or whatever it might be. And also I wanted my offers to kind of stand out among all the other offers that these people are getting. And so I felt like by having those multiple steps, if their notifications on their phone are turned on, they are getting a notification about my follow. They're getting a notification about the bundle, about the comment, and about the offer. And that's four things that are popping up all for me. And I feel like it stands out a little bit more. And they're probably more likely to go in and actually look at the offer, look at the comment that I left them, and therefore maybe be more likely to buy it. That was always kind of my rationale for it. And overall, I felt like this has actually really worked for me. And that's why I've done it for so long. But I never actually had any proof of this. And so here I am on this channel telling you, oh, this is the best way to send offers when I actually don't really know. But have no fear, the results of this experiment are actually very drastic. Like the two strategies are so different in the results that I saw for this period of time. So I do actually kind of feel like I have an answer as to which offer strategy is the best. Recently, the past couple of months, my life has kind of picked up the pace a little bit. I'm right in the middle of student teaching right now, actually, and it's been an amazing experience, but it does take up a lot of my time. And so I don't have the opportunity or the time to be on my phone all day long, constantly checking for likes, constantly sending messages. So I really, really needed something like this experiment to make it apparent to me if this work was actually even worth my time doing. Because at this point I'm feeling so busy and so overwhelmed that if I don't have to be sending messages and I can just do the offer feature button, that would be ideal. So let's jump right into it. As with all of my Poshmark experiment videos, I want to lay out kind of the details of how I set up the experiment. Then we'll talk about the exact results and the data that I got from it. And then I have some conclusions about what happened with this. All right, so first things first, this was a 2-week experiment. I spent the whole first week doing what I normally do, my normal habit, my normal pattern, following that person, adding it to a bundle, leaving a comment on the bundle, and sending them the offer. I did that exactly the same for the first week, which was Sunday, March 21st through Saturday, March 27th. And then the following week, which was Sunday, March 28th through Saturday, April 3rd, I did not send any messages or add it to any bundles. For the people that liked things from my closet during that period of time, I did follow them because I wanted to be able to keep track of the different profiles and accounts that I had actually already sent offers to. If you've watched my channel for a while, you know that I don't follow people on a day-to-day basis. So if I had clicked on a profile, saw that I was already following them, that signaled to me that I had already sent them an offer as part of this experiment for that 1 week. And then after I followed them, I just went back to the listing and sent them the offer. I had no communication with them. I sent them no message, nothing like that. Another important thing to know about this experiment is that I sent the same level of offers throughout both weeks. So I always, always, always send out 20% off and discounted shipping, no matter what the item, no matter what the day. Like that's my baseline. I always send 20% off, discounted shipping, $4.99 shipping also. I know that Poshmark is kind of rolling this out little by little. I saw other people had this feature before I did, but there's starting to be this option now that when you are sending offers to likers, you can choose to give sort of an even smaller shipping discount. So you can charge them $5.95 for their shipping, you can charge them $4.99 for their shipping, or you can give them free shipping. Up until this feature, it has always been that your shipping discount would equate to them paying $4.99. So I'm just sticking with that. I don't care about the $1. dollar, it's whatever. I feel like people are generally used to getting that $4.99 shipping deal. And before this feature was available to me, or before I even knew about it, I got an offer from somebody on something that I had liked, and it had that $5.95 shipping on it. And I was like, what is this? Like, why is it not $4.99? It's always been $4.99. Why can't it be $4.99? So whatever, personal preference, but for the purposes of this experiment, I wanted to point out that through both weeks, all of my discounts were the same. I wasn't like giving a better discount one week than the other or anything like that. During both of these weeks, I was just keeping track of who I was sending offers to. So for the first week of time, I was tracking who got a message with their offer, and for the second week, who just got the flat out offer. And from those people, I was also tracking how many resulted in a sale, how many accepted my offer, how many sales did I make from that. And then at the end of each week, I went back and I saw how many sales I had divided by the number of messages or offers that I sent, and I got what I would call an acceptance rate. I don't just want to say, oh, I made this many sales the first week and this many sales the last week, because the number of offers that I sent were different. Every single week is so different on Poshmark. The amount of likes I'm getting, the amount of offers that I'm receiving, the amount of sales I'm making, like it's so different on a week-to-week basis. So that's why I'm gonna frame the data in sort of like an acceptance rate type of thing. So instead of just saying this is how many sales I got, I'm saying this is how many sales I got in proportion to how many offers I sent. And with that, let's get into some numbers here. So for that first week, the week that I was doing what I normally do, and I still was sending people a little message or a little comment on their bundle, just kind of reaching out and letting them know that I sent them an offer, I ended up sending 140 offers with that message attached. And 5 of those people that I sent an offer to went through and actually just accepted the offer that I sent them. I also feel like it's worth mentioning that for this, I'm not including anything that was like a full price sale, and I'm not including anything where they made me an offer first. Those are excluded from this data. I'm only talking about the sales I made from the actual messages and offers that I sent. So I made 5 sales out of the 140 messages and offers that I sent, which comes out to be a 3.6% acceptance rate. I will say that that seems super low to me, actually. Like if you were to ask me how many sales come from doing this, I would have guessed that it would have been a lot higher of a percentage than that. But all in all, 5 sales that week, I can't complain about that. For the second week, when I sent no messages and all I did was follow that person and send them an offer through offers to likers, I ended up sending out 114 offers and I only made 2 sales. This comes out to be roughly a 1.8% acceptance rate. So not great, but let's break this down a little bit. I have a lot of thoughts. So if we are comparing these acceptance rates, I had a 3.6% acceptance rate when I did send them a message, and I had only a 1.8% acceptance rate when I did not send them a message. And what that pretty much comes down to, at least for this set of data during these 2 specific weeks in time, is that people were twice as likely to accept my offer if I sent them a message. Sending offers to likers without a message resulted in half the number of accepted offers. But of course, I do feel like it is worth pointing out that this could be for a variety of things, right? It could depend on the pay periods, it could depend on who is just willing and able to buy certain things on certain weeks. It's pretty much impossible to just isolate the offers to liker strategy and be able to say, oh, this is for sure the best way to do it. Because of course, the buying and spending habits of other people is not consistent week to week. So just keep that in mind too. But there is something pretty interesting that happened after this experiment concluded that I feel like it's worth mentioning here. I had a 3-day dry spell of no sales at all on April 1st, 2nd, and 3rd. This was that tail end of that week when I wasn't sending any messages, and I just had no sales for 3 days. April 3rd was sort of the cutoff for that week and for this experiment. And so April 4th, I went back to my normal habit of sending messages to likers when I sent them an offer. And within 48 hours, I had made 4 sales from sending offers to likers with a message. I sent out 45 offers in that 48-hour period, which comes out to be an 8.9% acceptance rate in 48 hours after I went back to doing what I normally was doing. And as I keep saying, that could have a lot of underlying reasons as to why I had that high of an acceptance rate in those 48 hours. And I wasn't necessarily planning on tracking any data after April 3rd, like after the experiment had concluded, I guess. But after that 3-day dry spell, and then all of a sudden I make 4 sales, it was kind of like this drastic contrast that I felt like was worth mentioning at least. So in conclusion, if you want this like wrapped up in a nice neat bow, I'm gonna keep sending messages. That apparently is what is working for me, and I'm comfortable doing that. It is just like a little bit extra work, but ultimately if I'm seeing results out of it and I have learned that that's what I need to be doing, that's what I'm gonna keep doing. And I'm a little bit relieved to know that I didn't like waste a year of my life doing something that wasn't actually the best way, so thank goodness for that. And with that, that is everything that I have for you for this video. I would love to hear about what your strategy is when sending offers to likers and what you have found is working the best for you. And if you were just sending offers and now you're deciding to try out sending messages, let me know how that's working for you. I would be super interested to know how that's going. Thank you so much for watching this video. I really appreciate you, and I will see you in my next one real soon.